It's time again for Victory Videos. Hi, I'm Dave Dobbins.
And I'm LaVila Kraft.
Welcome to our program. Today we've got some new videos, we've got great music, and more importantly, we've got something special we're going to cover on today's program. LaVila?
Yes, we're going to see how God can really intervene and help you through some struggles in everyday life like He has for First Call and some hard times that they went through a while back.
That's right. We're going to visit with them today on our program, and it's going to be really good. So let's get started as we kick off with...
The Monkees.
No, it's not the Monkees.
I mean Amy Morris. I'm sorry.
Amy Morris and I'm a Believer.
I'm a Believer.
Followed by Pam Thumb. And life is hard, but God is good.
Yes, that's right.
He is really good.
To heal a situation, when I reach out, God will behind you. Drop your bags on the floor. You reach for the light, but there's darkness deep inside, and you can't take it anymore. 'Cause sometimes living takes the life out of you, and sometimes living is all you can do. Life is hard, the world is cold, we're barely young and we're old, but every falling tear is always understood. Life is hard. Strong for so long, but that's not how you feel. Oh, you try to pray, but there's nothing left to say, so you just quietly kneel. In the silence of all that you face, journey home. God is good.
Coming up on Victory Videos, we've got music from First Call and...
And right after the break, you'll get to meet him.
That's right.
How long's the break?
I don't know. It's in a few minutes.
Where'd my watch go?
They've given our generation a label. X. Generation Nothing. They say we have no sense of purpose. They say we have no war to fight and no cause to believe in. Who are they? Join the thousands of us who are making a difference and wear a label that does mean something.
Thanks for watching Victor Videos. I'm Dave Dobbins. We'd like to hear from you today. Tell us which videos you'd like to see on Victor Videos. If you have a prayer request, just drop us a note. Or if you need some information about Victor Videos, write to us at Victor Videos, Post Box 3292, Cincinnati, Ohio 45201. That's Victor Videos, Post Box 3292, Cincinnati, Ohio 45201.
Hi, this is First Call.
And you're watching Victory Videos, and we'll be coming up later with our news video from our new record called
First Call.
Hello, we're Daryl and Julie Pierce, your hosts for On the Way on New Life 93 WAKW from every afternoon, Monday through Friday, 2 until 6.
And if you check it out, you will notice we have added even more of your favorite music, even in the afternoon, and then during On the Way, we've got extra of your favorite and Christian music. Plus, I think just about every day we're giving something away because we want as many of you to win as possible.
And we try to have a lot of fun, too, on the way and 2 until 6 on New Life 93.
Hey, honey, I'm ready for that steak dinner you promised me. You got it ready yet?
I thought you were cooking.
And you're back on Victor Videos. Thanks for joining us. Up next, it's a story about two of the members of First Call who went through tremendous odds and still stood strong. This is a story about God reigning. You may not be aware of it. Several years ago, Michael English, Christian singer, and one of the members of First Call, former member, who's no longer in the group, were involved in an affair. A pregnancy followed and a miscarriage followed. But what also followed was First Call being totally ostracized from the Christian music industry. They were rejected. They lost everything.
But out of all of that, there came healing and there's hope in Christ. And you're just going to see how God took these two people and lifted them back up because they trusted in Him. It's really inspiring.
That's right.
So you stay tuned.
You betcha. These two remaining members of First Call, we're going to meet them right now on Victor Videos. And we're on Victor Videos. Welcome to our program, First Call. Hi, how are you doing?
Very nice.
Thanks for being with us. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
As we said just a moment ago, Marty, you have been in this Christian music business for an awful long time. It's so good to finally meet you.
And it wasn't all awful.
Yeah.
Just long.
Yeah, long. I saw you from the audience. You were up on stage doing your thing with Marty McCollum, Fireworks, which is a long time ago.
Yep.
And you're doing a wonderful thing with Bonnie here. What's new? Tell us what's happening with First Call.
Well,
after
10 years of doing First Call and sort of figuring out what it was that God wanted to do with First Call as a ministry and giving ourselves over to that and submitting to that, we lost our third member a couple of years ago now and went through a real devastating time. Mm-hmm. But it provided Bonnie and me personally with an opportunity to go back to our knees about the Christian music industry at large and about First Call and exactly, you know, how vital is this? How important is it? Is it really something the Lord wants to do? I think a lot of artists would probably enjoy the opportunity to kind of, you know, stop what they're doing and start over from square one and say, exactly what is it about this ministry that I feel like is God's?
Mm-hmm.
And Bonnie and I have had that opportunity,
and we've
done it, and it's taken us 2 years to kind of get back around to that. But we feel like that He's given us a new focus for First Call, for the ministry of First Call. He's certainly done away with, trashed a lot of the unimportant things about the music industry and in our lives, and allowed us to really focus on wanting to be about His work and wanting to be about Him in our own lives. So we've had a good but hard opportunity.
She learned to receive.
nothing, especially love. And later on, the question whispered like a sparrow in her ear, burned like a fire in her spirit. Will I find?
Lost everything, and we did lose everything, has allowed us to be able to relate to other people now, a different kind of ministry element, which is hope, in a way that having everything lost and starting all over again and not really knowing, and having it lost in a very devastating, hurtful way, has the fact that we're still here, the new record's called First Call, and we've never had a self-titled album after 12 albums. We wanted the statement to be, look, God still is doing something with us. If he can do that with us, he can do that with you. Where you feel lost, where you feel hopeless, let us encourage you that God's grace can really go into the nitty-gritty ugliness of what we all have to deal with as human beings here. And this record is truly, for us, a gift from God's and his grace that we're still here. And we hope that other people will hear the record and hear that in the songs. Yes. There's songs about healing and moving on and leaving things behind, not to let them make you bitter. Learning how to walk in forgiveness and grace and extend that to other people that maybe it's hard to extend it to. Yes. Now, we never would have come to that place maybe as poignantly if we hadn't gone through losing what we did the way we did. So we feel like, you know, God has really been gracious to teach us a lot, break us, you know, let
you
us
hate to be broken.
It was a severe mercy. It was a difficult, traumatic time.
Yes.
But out of it, maybe God can use First Call even more than we've been used in the past.
Oh,
we
sure.
didn't want to continue on as a trio. We felt like we had done 10 years of work as a trio. That died with the loss of the member that we had.
Yes.
And so we thought, what will we do? Well, God really impressed upon us to continue on together. And then Warner Brothers came in, and Warner Alliance, Neil Joseph, who first signed us 10 years ago at a different label, is now there, said, what do you guys want to do? And we told him, he said, let's do it. And have been so supportive.
Hallelujah.
And we've seen God really use us in concert more powerfully than ever. Mm. People want to say, y'all are still here, you know, and you know what happened to me a couple of years ago or whatever, you know, and then all of a sudden there's this whole different deepening of our ministry out of this that we're so grateful for. I think it's forever changed who we are.
Sitting in an all-night cafe, feeling far away from you and still so close. Try to close the distance, whispering your name, and I feel your touch. There's a dream I've been chasing, long overdue. This heart that's aching knows it's true that your love can bring us together. Forever, I know. When
Hey, Dave.
Yeah,
got something cool coming up.
What's up?
Guess what? Big Choir.
Big Choir.
Like Big Choir?
I like Big Choir.
You like Andre Crouch?
I like Andre
Crouch.
He's
coming up.
Stay tuned. Victor Videos.
A dream, but never the chance to achieve it. That is perhaps the greatest tragedy in life. The United Negro College Fund exists to bring the dreams of thousands of young people within reach. Hands that yearn to touch lives. We train to heal, to teach, to bless. We encourage souls that hear music to write symphonies and sing anthems. And to those once bound by poverty, we present a wealth of possibilities. When you support the United Negro College Fund, you give more than money. You give dreams that may have died, the power to live.
Support the United Negro College Fund. A mind is a terrible thing to waste.
Back.
Where were we?
I don't know. Hello. Welcome to Inside Report of Victory Videos. We're Daryl and Julie Pierce, your hosts from On the Way on 2 to 6 on New Life 93.
I'm sorry, did I almost interrupt you? We are really glad to be here on Victory Videos to host Inside Report. We'll be bringing you the latest stories and all the news information on your favorite contemporary Christian artists.
So for this week, why don't we start off with some encouraging news, not about teenagers committing suicide or doing drugs or getting into other trouble, but some stories about teenagers and young adults doing some great things.
In a recent issue of Christianity Today, Rebecca St. James and DC Talk were recognized on the list of the top 50 evangelical leaders under the age of 40.
Definitely some good representatives there. You know, Michael W. Smith, speaking of, let's see, is he under 40? I don't know, I can't tell you that. But he obviously enjoys surprising people, as he did at the Christ Presbyterian Academy, where they were hosting a benefit. He just up and sang a brand new song off of a praise and worship album that he's working on. There's no word yet, though, when that album is going to be released.
Okay, listen up. Cindy Morgan's latest release, Listen, it was actually written by her dad 25 years ago. I'm sure her father is very proud of Cindy's rendition.
That is definitely true. By the way, did you know that Cindy Morgan is now engaged to Sigmund Brouwer? He wrote a book for Word. It's a suspense thriller. Speaking of suspense and thrills, Amy Morris just gave birth to her first little girl, Emma Lee, and congratulations to Amy and her husband.
Well, it's a new year, and we want to thank you for joining us on Victory Videos. Julie actually has a significant birthday recently.
That's enough. Thank you. Anyway, we'd also like to have you join us for On the Way on New Life 93 WAKW.
30.
Enjoy the rest of Victory Videos. I'm going to. He, however, we have to go talk.
30. Okay, we're back in the deep blue, the heart of Victor Videos.
We need to throw some fish in
That's
there.
Where we live over there on the right side. No.
I think you've lost it, Dave.
I have lost it. Welcome back. Hope you're enjoying our show so far. And as I said in the beginning, this is a show that, boy, if you need a little hope,
yes.
This is good for you. Up next is a guy who has been in Christian music since the 70s.
Since he was way a back leader. When?
Yeah, when I became a Christian a long time ago, he was one of the leaders, LaVilla. His name's Andre Crouch, and he gathered together a huge cast of singers, and we're going to give God the glory. It's called To God Be the Glory. You're going to love it.
And then to follow up, we're going to see the rest of the story with First Call, so you hang in there.
That's right. It's going to be good. Up next on Victor Videos.
Where's the fish?
Okay, where's your watch? I want to.
As we kind of close this out, Marty, what would you share with people who maybe are going through a really tough storm not only Scott Crepane is not the only one that sings about those storms.
Right.
But as they're going through that storm, what kind of bit of hope as we close this down that can you give them
to hold on?
I think
one thing that's very important is to be patient. If Bonnie and I had tried to jump back, you know, maybe a year ago and say, well, we've moved on and we're going beyond this, we wouldn't have been ready to. You have to do it in God's timing, because there's a lot of, you know, healing is a very complex process. You know, he has to heal often many different aspects and bring you to things. You know, we've spoken forgiveness to people that we've felt that was important to do, but it didn't come immediately. You know, you can have sort of prematurely try to move on. Mm-hmm. And I think the main thing is that sometimes sitting with our pain is God's way, staying with it and not being afraid of it and letting him minister to us and keep pouring his Holy Spirit over us and ministering to us in spite of it. And, you know, if we keep listening to him, he's going to show us when we need to take action, when we need to speak forgiveness.
Yeah, and another thing I would say, don't be afraid to just collapse on God. Mm. Because I was afraid that I thought I had to do everything in my own strength until this happened, and have learned, and Marty and I both have, that God has only restored First Call out of his grace. We're only here because of his grace. He's there for everybody in that way. And so when you get to that point where you just can't do it anymore yourself, that's maybe the best place you can be.
I'm hearing three things as we kind of wrap this up. I'm hearing stay, collapse if you need to, and then stand under his grace.
Amen.
First Call. God is using you guys. Thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
You can see the evidence of his love.
Thanks.
Here they are. First Call, an evidence of love. Victor Videos. God bless. Thank you.
It is written in the colors of a thousand autumn twilights, painted in the eyes of a child. Spoken as forgiveness by an honest open hand. It's a friend who will walk the extra mile.
Next, it's Ray Bolts. He's still playing and recording. That's right. You got that new hairdo going on.
All the guys got new hairdos now.
I know. I like it.
I think they're
it.
Hitting 40,
don't
you
change.
Think?
We got more, Ray Bolts. No, what are you?
Okay.
I heard you
do it up a little
bit. No, wait. Don't.
Gee, Vince, what kind of dummy wouldn't know how to use a child safety seat?
Beats me, lads. Child's play.
You just buckle him in.
Unless he's over 20 pounds.
Then this one's good.
Except if he's over 40 pounds.
Then you're into this kind of rig.
What if he outgrows that?
Put him in a booster seat?
What if he's too big for a booster seat?
Would he use the safety belt?
The Auto Safety Hotline can tell you everything you need to know about keeping your child safe in a car.
I'm a wreck.
Totaled.
You could learn a lot from a dummy. Call 1-800-424-9393.
Don't tell them you love it. Watching Victory Videos. I am Dave Dobbins. Join me in La Villa Craft each week as we bring you the very best in today's contemporary Christian music videos. Victory Videos is your source for all of your favorite artists, including Stephen Curtis Chapman, DC Talk, and For Him, just to name a few. Great music, entertaining yet thought-provoking conversations, interesting interviews with today's top Christian recording artists. The mixture makes Victory Videos a powerful and exciting program to watch. Tell somebody today about Victory Videos.
Yo, we are Christafari. You're watching the best in Christian music videos on Victory Videos. Because through Christ we have the victory.
Todd Stack from WNLT 104.3 FM. Hey, if you don't know that we're in Cincinnati, you should now. We're located on 104.3 FM on your FM dial. Okay, 24 hours of Christian music, all the time Christian music, continuous Christian music. Tune in sometime. Now back to Victory Videos with your host Dave Dobbins and La Villa Craft.
Well, welcome back to Victory Videos. I've got to thank First Call for sharing this experience with us because it's really encouraging to see that you can go through such horrible struggles like they did and come out on top because they trusted Jesus to see them through it.
And you know, LaVilla, we're strengthened through those difficult times, as I'm sure that we've gone through difficult times, mm-hmm. our viewers have, and First Call has. And God sometimes takes us through those struggles to make us stronger and really to make us rely upon Him.
Mm-hmm. So it's a learning and growing process.
If you're going through a struggle, it's time maybe to just rely on Him.
That's the truth.
Let's get back to music. It's Ray Bolts in One Drop of Blood on Victory Videos.
That's all it takes.
Now.
Just one.
Yeah. Amen. Just the one.
Yes.
Yeah.
as others were bribing. I saw them start to tremble when they turned and faced their sin. They offered no excuse, they offered no alibi. The truth was overwhelming and it would not be denied. Their righteousness like filthy rags, and nothing they could say. They bowed their heads in silence as they were led away. Before the true believers, each time it was the same. His glory shone around them as they called upon his name. One drop of love fell to the scale and covered their transgression and all the times they failed. The enemy was mighty, he came in like a flood. He was defeated by one drop of love. No greater sacrifice has any other made. Oh yes, he paid the price with every drop he gave.
Well, welcome back. We are so glad that you joined us today. We had a lot of fun. It was interesting seeing First Call and hearing about their story. It was just so inspiring.
Great
and
video,
you know what?
From Ray.
Oh, and Ray Bolts, that was wonderful, wasn't it? And I do like your new do, Ray. Hey, oh, and the viewers, we got to tell you, if you want more information about Victory Videos, you want to know what goes on behind the scenes, meet some of our crew members, if you want to know scheduling, air times, and all of that, we have our webpage. The address will be listed, so you can go check us out.
That's right. Mm-hmm. We're on the World Wide Web now, so anything you want to know, just kind of look us up. And also, you can still write us at Victory Videos, Post Box 3292, Cincinnati, Ohio, 45201. We'd love to hear from you. And don't forget that Jesus loves you. He cares about you just like he does even LaVila and I.
Yeah.
Even
he
us.
Really does.
Even us.
Till next week, it's Dave Dobbins.
And LaVila Kraft.
Saying, remember to love somebody today with the love of Jesus. We'll see you. Bye-bye.
Thanks. We love you.
No, I love you.
I do too.
No, I love you.
We do.
No, but I love you.